OMG, boys. We got fish for the pond.
Hey, welcome back, guys. Today, we're finally gonna get some fish for the pond. I made you guys wait long enough. I made myself wait long enough for this. I mean, it's almost July. I think we set the pond up like a month ago, maybe even longer. Yeah, the end of May, so about a month. It just took me a long time to decide what I wanted to put in there. There's lots of choices, but the first thing that was really important was that they would be a fish that if we left the pond out during the winter could sustain those cold temperatures. So I had to keep that in mind, and I ended up picking a fish that can definitely do that if we decide to leave the pond out. So I'm just gonna go ahead and tell you what we're gonna go pick up from the fish store. We're gonna go get 20 to 30 golden white cloud minnows. I'm deciding to go with the golden white clouds instead of the regular ones because I think they're gonna be a little bit easier to see from above. Okay, they almost have like a pink appearance to them. We'll see how they end up actually looking in my pond, but we gotta go to the fish store and pick them up. So let's go do that and then we'll come back and check them out.
So these fish have already been acclimating here for about 30 minutes. The temperature of the pond right now is about 75 degrees. 76 maybe back there on the little digital thermometer that we have. And so I think it's time we get these guys in their new home. Let's take one quick peek at them here before we put them in. This is the last time that we're probably gonna be able to see them from this angle. Very cool fish. All right, guys, so the fish have been in the pond now for about 3 days. And you guys, if you watch a lot, you know that whenever we get new fish, I typically do this. I get something, I let it sit for a couple days, see how it does, and then I try and get you, I guess, the first update in the same video so you know how everything's doing. So everything is doing pretty good. Let's take a look at them. Still got Mr. Duck in here. He hasn't flown away yet. Here they are, guys, all kind of spread out here in the open. When I first put them in, they all balled up. You know how fish do. And they swam right for under this cover, under all the water hyacinth, where it's nice and shaded. And so they spent the first day pretty much hanging out there. They did kind of navigate their way around the pond, get used to their new habitat, but now they definitely spend a lot more time out in the open. They are not shy. I can tell that they're having a good time in here. Can't really compare them to the regular minnows, like color-wise and how easy it is to see them compared to those fish, but you can tell right off the bat that these are easy to spot in the pond, and they do have kind of like a yellowish, pinkish coloration to them, and I think they go perfect in here. They of course have their red finnage that's also really easy to spot, and when they go over these raised parts of the pond that are black, you can totally get a good look at them. Let's grab some food though and watch these fish eat a little bit. It's definitely lunchtime for these guys. Let's go with some Hikari micro pellets. That's what I've been feeding the last couple of days. They seem to really like this stuff. It's kind of windy today. This duck will not stop moving. Get over here, dude. Stay put. Thank you.
we'd let the sun go down a little bit before we talk about the rest of the pond, guys. You saw the fish on a little feeding frenzy. They're all still up at the top of the water here looking for some food. They're hungry fish, man. I can't believe it. But we'll keep feeding them, don't worry. But let's talk about the rest of the pond here. So let's start over here with the papyrus. You can see there's a broken stem right here. I'll have to break that off. I'll do that a little later. But this plant has grown a considerable amount up here. I think when we got it, it was down about here. The grasses in the back, not a part of the pond, just kind of like an accent plant that we put in the planters back here. You can see those. When we got those, I talked about, hey, they're gonna get to be about as tall as the fence, maybe even taller, and they're already up to the top of the fence. Pretty crazy. The water celery is just spreading all over the place. That's kind of like the main plant in the pond, I guess. It's in the filter of the pond, as well as the water mint here. Snipped off that top piece that wasn't doing well. There's a couple pieces that are looking a little yellow, but the plant as a whole is doing well, getting a lot of new growths out of here. And the Liquigia starting to creep over the edge here of the pond. Can't wait until we get it down to the bottom of the deck. That's gonna happen very soon. The water hyacinth is doing okay. There's quite a few of the older leaves that aren't doing too well. I should probably get in there and snip those off maybe. Not 100% sure. I mean, this is my first time keeping this plant, but I mean, the root systems are looking good. Just the top foliage isn't looking the most healthy that I've ever seen. We'll keep an eye on that as the pond progresses. I guess the only other plant that's really something that I'm watching, besides, you know, we put the weeds in here, they're doing fine. We're actually getting some flowering here. Check these out right here. Those weren't there when we planted them, so those are doing fine, but again, they're just weeds. But the dwarf sedge is starting to propagate. So we can see little daughter plants being spread around down here. And like I said, I mean, it takes a few weeks, maybe a month, maybe a little bit longer, but before we know it, this entire bottom of the pond will be covered in dwarf sedge. I can't wait for that. I think it's gonna look awesome. The filter is still running strong. I'm getting good oxygenation out of this thing. Remember, we redid the filter and brought the holes up a little bit higher to create a little bit more oxygenation, and I think the fish really appreciate that, as well as the entire system that is the pond. I also added in a couple pieces of Sylvinia because I want to see if that will take a hold in here. I'm pretty much sure that it will. I mean, the dwarf water lettuce has done a fantastic job. You see all those new growths down there. I'm thinking that the Sylvinia will do just fine. It'll spread out and I'll just have a bunch more of it. A good alternative to duckweed as far as a top level nutrient absorber, something that you can easily remove if you want to. I think it'll make a cool addition to here. Look at the duck. It's just moving around in here. It's getting windy right now. But I don't know, the pond is great. The pond is just doing really good, guys. And I'm really excited to see what it does in the next couple of months as the summer progresses and these plants continue to grow. I wanted to show you guys this as kind of a fun trick, something that I've been doing. So remember these grasses over here, which we talked about a little earlier, are planted in three individual pots. So what I do to water them is sometimes, more times than not, I take the input of the filter, I just pull it out of the filter. I forgot there's a clamp on here. We take this off, we pull this out, and we can spray it directly into the pots to water these guys. So we get the good nutrient water from the pond down on these grasses, help them to grow nice and strong. And then when we're done, we can put it back into the filter and keep filtering the water for our fish. I wanted to bring you guys an in-depth look at the pond at nighttime. It's about 10 o'clock, so it's not completely dark, but here you can still see elements of the pond as well as the lights being on. It just looks really cool out here. It's really nice to come out and just get some fresh air at nighttime when it's cooled down. Take all that the pond has to offer in and just check things out. Let's see if we can still see the fish. Might be kind of hard, but I can see them with my eyes. The camera, I don't think, is going to pick them up, but all in all, the pond is really coming together. Anyway, I think that's going to do it for today's video, guys. I hope you enjoyed finally getting to see the fish that we put in the pond. We'll see if there's some more to come. I have a couple ideas of maybe a few more fish to add, so be sure to stay tuned. Don't forget to subscribe. If you're new, hit the notification bell so you know when I upload the next video. As always, guys, thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.